Blogging, we started blogging in Egypt in the end of 2004, and we started forming a small community of the Egyptian bloggers. And in 2005, it began to play a very important role. On the May, I think it was May 25th of 2005, there was a referendum on a change in the constitution, and many political groups have decided they want to boycott this referendum because they thought it was a farce that changed that. And the Mubarak regime wanted to crack down on these protests. And they used new methods and strategies for the first time, like targeting women and sexually harassing them, also targeting journalists and stealing their cameras or breaking them, and confiscating memory cards from journalists they arrest. So by the end of the day, there was no media coverage of that event because a lot of the journalists have lost their equipment. But the bloggers who have just begun to get some attention and to grow and to get a little bit known have been there, have participated in the protest and reported it and covered it. And some of them had some photos on their mobiles or their cameras, their portable cameras, so they put it online. There was also an effort to collect all the photos because there were not much coverage to collect all the photos and testimonies and also SMSs that have been sent between the protesters and their friends when they were screaming for help or shouting about what's happening. And we created a document, we called it Never Forget, about the protest on the 25th of May. This got a lot of attention because it was almost the only coverage of the event. And this was when a lot of people started to try to find out what are these blogs and follow up. The bloggers themselves, and these bloggers started to gain some trust from the people, because from then on they started organizing more protests, covering them, covering other events, even covering local events, and from this they gained a lot of trust from the readers, and then a lot of readers, and even the traditional media started to cover the blogs and the news the blogs covered themselves. It's very important to have that kind of citizen media, because even the big newspapers, they don't cover all the cities, all the places in Egypt. It's mainly news about Cairo and maybe some little news from the main cities like Alexandria, but not even instant news. So it's very important to have local bloggers to tell you what's happening in their local, in their cities, what's the events that's taking place, what are the important issues or problems that's happening there. For example, there was a big sectarian strife in Alexandria, and a lot of it was a very long event, but the news reporters, by the time they reached, it has already happened. It needed some local Alexandrian to go and cover from their own perspective. And we had that. We had bloggers from Alexandria who went in and attended most of the event. And when they returned, they wrote down the eyewitness account, what exactly they saw, what they felt. So it's very important to have local news and coverage from all the area, not just the capital.